Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to see Standard 8 History, Chapter Number 12, India Gains Independence. During the period of Second World War, Indian freedom struggle had become more extensive. The demand for independence of India was gaining its strength. The British rulers realized that it was necessary to take a serious note of it. Accordingly, the British government started preparing various plans for granting independence to India. The Indian National Congress was founded on the principles of secularism. People of all caste and religion had taken part in the national struggle. To weaken this movement, the British adopted the policy of divide and rule. Its consequences was the establishment of Muslim League. See here, according to it, as the strength of our Indian people, it had been started for the independence of our country. So according to this, the British government has started preparing various plans for granting independence to India. The British rulers, they had realized that it was necessary to take a serious note of it. Under this, the Indian National Congress was founded on the principles of secularism, and the people of all castes of religion had to take part in the national struggle. According to it, to weaken the power of British government, which had been adopted by the policy of divide and rule, which was started by British government for Indian people. Into their caste. In 1930, Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, a well-known poet, put forth the thought of an independent Muslim state. Later, Chaudhry Rehmat Ali put up the idea of Pakistan. Barrister Muhammad Ali Jinnah put forth the two-nation theory and demanded a separate Muslim nation named Pakistan. So as previously in 1930, Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, a well-known poet, he put the thought of an independent Muslim state, and under this, the Chaudhry Rehmat Ali, he put up the idea of Pakistan, and Barrister Muhammad Ali Jinnah, he put forth the theory of two-nation theory. Under this, he demanded a separate nation for the as a Pakistan for the Muslim League. Indian National Congress was only a Hindu organization. The Muslims have no benefit of it. Such kind of propaganda was started by Barrister Jinnah and the Muslim League. So as Indian National Congress, this is the Hindu organization, and for this we want a different league as a Muslim League for the Muslim people. This was the propaganda of Barrister Jinnah. Under this theory, he put forth the theory of two nations theory, and they want a separate nation as Pakistan. Wavell plan. In June 1945, Lord Wavell, the Viceroy of India, drew up a plan. There were different provisions in this plan. Accordingly, some of its provisions were that in central and provincial legislatures, Muslims, Dalits and minorities should be given proper representation, and there will be equal number of Hindu and Muslim members in Viceroy's Executive Council. A meeting of all major political parties in India was organized at Shimla to consider the Wavell plan. Barrister Jinnah insisted that only the names of Muslim representatives to the Viceroy's Executive Council, but the Congress opposed it. Therefore, the Wavell plan could not be successful. So, under this Wavell plan, in June 1945, Lord Wavell, he was the Viceroy of India, who drew up a plan of having the Indian Pakistan as a two nation. As according to it, some of its provisions were that to its central and provisional legislatures, Muslims and Dalit and minorities should be given a proper representation. So for this, a equal number of Hindu and Muslim members in Viceroy Executive Council meeting should be arranged. And according to this meeting, major political parties in India was organized, which was at Shimla. According to this Wavell plan, Barrister Jinnah, he had insisted that the Muslim League should have the right to suggest the names who will attend the, or who will be a representative of from the Muslim. But the Viceroy Executive Council, he opposed to this, due to which the Wavell plan was unsuccessful. Cabinet mission. after the end of Second World War, the British rulers were in favor of granting freedom to India. In the Parliament, British Prime Minister Attlee clarified the British policy regarding India. According to it, the right of Indian people to draft their own constitution was recognized. It was also made clear that the issues of minorities will not come in the way of India's independence. In March 1946, a delegation of British ministers, namely Patrick Lawrence, Stafford Cripps and Abby Alexander, put forth England's plan regarding India in front of the Indian leaders. This is called a cabinet mission. So let's see what is cabinet mission. Cabinet mission. Under this cabinet mission, he clarified that the policies regarding India and under this, the rights through Indian people should be drafted their own constitution so that they can, after independence, they can follow that constitutional law book. And also, it was also made clear that the issues of minorities will not come in the way of India's independence. And from March 1946, a delegation of British ministers, namely Patrick Lawrence and Stafford Cripps and A.V. Alexander, they put forth the England plan regarding India in front of the Indian leaders. So as a cabinet mission under the Patrick Lawrence, Stafford Cripps and A.V. Alexander, under this, the cabinet mission was conducted. And they put forth the England's plan regarding India in front of the Indian people or Indian leaders. Some of the provision in the plan were not acceptable to the Congress. Similarly, there was no provision of independent state for the Muslims. So the Muslim League was unsatisfied. Therefore, cabinet mission was not successful, not fully accepted. So as according to the cabinet mission plan, as the Muslim League was unsatisfied with the decision, due to which the cabinet mission plan was not successful. Direct Action Day. Since the demand for Pakistan was not being fulfilled, the Muslim League decided for direct action. Accordingly, 16 August 1946 was declared to be observed as Direct Action Day by the Muslim League. The followers of Muslim League resorted to violent ways. There were Hindu-Muslim riots in various parts of the country. There were massacres in the Nakholi regions in the province of Bengal. To stop this violence, Gandhiji went there without giving any thought to his own life. He tried his best to establish peace there. So as under this, the Direct Action Day was taken place. Since the demand of Pakistan was not being fulfilled, so as Muslim League, they had decided to take a direct action. According to it, on 16 August 1946, they had declared observed as a direct action day for the demand of Muslim League. And different followers of Muslim League, they had resorted to violent ways in all over the part of country for having a Muslim League or a Pakistan as a state or as a country. So under these different massacres which had been taken place at the Nakholi region, and under this, which is in Bengal, and for this, to stop this violence, Gandhiji, he went without thinking about his life and tried to stop this situation or to make control over this situation. Establishment of interim government. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the head of this government. The Muslim League initially denied to participate in the interim government, but later participated in it. But since the leaders of Muslim League adopted the policy of obstruction, hence the interim government could not work smoothly. So under this, the establishment of interim government, under this violence had been arising in all the parts of our country. Viceroy Wavell, he established an interim government. Before this, the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he had not accepted this one. But after that, he became the head of this government, and the Muslim League initially, they had denied to participate in this interim government. They said that they will not be a member of this, or they will not be a member of this interim government. So under this also, due to this problem, the interim government also not work properly. Mountbatten plan. England's Prime Minister Minister Attlee had announced that England would leave its dominion on India before June 1948. On the background of transfer of power in India, Lord Mountbatten was appointed as Viceroy of India. Mountbatten held discussions with prominent leaders of India. Thereafter, he prepared a plan of creation of India and Pakistan as two independent nations. Indian National Congress opposed the plan of partition. Unity of the nation was the basic stand of Indian National Congress, but the Muslim League remained adamant on the creation of Pakistan. National Congress was left with no option but to accept the decision of partition with complete helplessness. So according to the Mountbatten plan, England's Prime Minister, Minister Attlee, he announced that the England would India, and Lord Button was appointed as a viceroy of our country, and Mountbatten had discussions with the prominent leaders of our country, and thereby they had decided to have a two nation, India and Pakistan. So under this, Indian National Congress has opposed for this plan of partition, and they said that unity of the nation will be ended. So to keep unity, the Indian National Congress had taken many measures, but the Muslim League, they had remained adamant on the creation of Pakistan. They had, the Muslim League, they had decided to have a Pakistan as a country. So due to which helplessly they have to accept that decision, and due to which India and Pakistan had been divided into two nations. India is divided into two nations as India 1 and Pakistan as a second part. Independent India, 15th August 1947. You can see Afghanistan as Rawalpindi. About this we have studied. West Pakistan, Delhi, India. India, the orange part, Pakistan, that is the part of pink color. And the dash dot, that is the boundaries of present external boundary of India. So these are the present external boundaries of our India. As before this, India and Pakistan was one. And after the independence, it had been divided into two nations as one Pakistan and one India due to demand of the Muslim League. India Independence Act on 18 July 1947, on the basis of Mountbatten plan, the Indian Independence Act was passed in British Parliament. On 15th of not have any control over them. The British supremacy over the princely states will also come to an end. The act provided them the right to either join India or Pakistan or remain independent. So as under this India Independence Act, under this on 18 July 1947, it was decided that according to the Mountbatten plan, the Indian Independence Act will be passed and the British Parliament will be act was passed by the British Parliament on 15th August 1947. The two independent nation theory, India and Pakistan, will be, these two will come in existence, and according to it, the British Parliament will not have any control over the our India as a ruler, and the British supremacy over the princely states will come to an end, and India and Pakistan will remain independent, and according to their constitutional law book, the India will rule. India gains independence. As per the Indian Independence Act, India was granted independence on 15th August 1947. A meeting of the Constituent Assembly was going on the Hall of Parliament House in Delhi in the midnight of 14th August 1947. At the stroke of midnight hour, India's independence came to an end. The Union Jack of Britain was lowered, and in its place the Indian tricolour flag was unfurled. India attained independence from the 150 years of slavery. So as India gains independence, under this, as per the Indian Independence Act, India was granted as an independence on 15th August 1947. As a constituent meeting was going on in the Hall of Parliament House in Delhi, in that they had decided in the midnight of 14th August 1947, at the stroke of 12 of midnight, that is 12 o'clock of night, India's independence will come to an India's dependence came to an end and the Union Jack of the Britain was lowered. The flag of Britain was lowered down and the tricolor of our country was unfurled on that the stroke. This decision was taken and Indian attained independence for last 150 years of slavery had come to an end and India became independent on 15th August 1947. The joy of attainment of freedom was not untainted. Indian people were grieved due to partition of the country and the terrible violence during that period. Instead of joining the celebration of independence, Gandhiji was striving hard in Bengal within 6 months of attainment of freedom of India. Gandhiji was brutally assassinated by Nathuram Godse. So as the joy of attainment of freedom was untitled, it means that the freedom that after 150 years as the Indian people, they got the freedom from the British rule and it was a happy time. But at that time, instead of celebrating that day, Gandhiji was striving hard in Bengal for the separation of India and Pakistan and to remove this casteism between the people and to unite them. But as Gandhiji was brutally assassinated by by the firing of Nathuram Godse on 30th January 1948, Gandhiji was died and his dream of preserving Hindu and Muslim unity was laid down, means it was not completed. And at last Hindu as a different electorate and Muslim League as a different electorate had been declared, and according to their choice, if they want to join Pakistan, the people can go and they can join Pakistan, and if they want to stay in same country in India, they can stay in India, and if they want to independent nation as like they can remain independent. This decision was taken. So in this way, this was the period where the India had gained independence for our country. As on 1930, Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, a famous poet, he put the thought of an independent Muslim state that we had studied in this chapter. Also, in this we had seen on 1946 on March Cabinet Mission Plan, the leaders Patrick Lawrence, Alfred Cripps and A.V. Alexander, they put the England's plan regarding India was explained to the Indian leaders by the representation of British ministers. On 16th August, the Direct Action Day was declared by the Muslim League. Again on 1947, 18th July, the Indian Independence Act was passed by the British Parliament, which was based on the Mountbatten Plan. And on the 14th August 1947, a meeting of the Constituent Assembly was going on in the Hall of the Parliament House in Delhi. Also on 15th August, as per the Indian Independence Act, it gained independence and became free from 150 years of slavery. And on 1948, 30th January, Mahatma Gandhi was mercilessly assassinated by the firing of Nathuram Godse. So this was the highlights which we had seen in this chapter. So in this way, we had completed this chapter. Read this chapter, complete exercise. That's all for today. Thank you.